besten dadurch, dass man die Trennstriche immer weiter ins Zentrum der CDU verlagert, dann sage ich gutes Gelingen, und euch darauf so zu verzwergen, wie die SPD verzwergt ist.
Damit sind wir bei dem Richtungsstreit und der Frage, muss die CDU sich weiter nach rechts bewegen, also weiter Richtung in die
konservative Seite,
Richtung in die Positionen, die im Moment nur von
der AfD vertreten werden, um die Wähler
der AfD zurückzuholen.
Noch einmal, das ist...
Oh my goodness, look at all these messages, I must answer them all. These are only messages from today. I need an administrator. This is too bad.
It's
unbelievable. 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 Talking about old Macs. I don't advise people to install Windows 10 on any old Mac now. But that video I created so many years ago, it's still there. I. Are we live? Oh, we are live. Hey! I didn't even know that we were live. Just kidding. Hello, welcome to Channel 48. Yeah, I was watching the news on the Samsung Galaxy S2. I've been testing it for a long time already, for several hours. And the thing is working really nice. I'm very happy about it. Okay, so welcome to the live show. My student and as well one of the main administrators here on Channel 48 for many years already, also a friend, Ruben, he got inspired after we start making all sorts of distros here on Channel 48, and he was like, Puck, I created a Windows 7 distro. I said, Windows 7 distro, oh nice, nice. I said, I was busy with something, the WinGNU thing from the other day. So I was like, you know what? I said, send me the distro and then I'm gonna make a video about it because yeah, I like these things. And he learned it all here at Channel 48, you know? So I'm very happy about, I'm proud. I'm proud tonight, I'm proud. Am I allowed to be proud? Can I be proud? Yeah, I'm allowed to be proud. So, let's not make this a long story because I talk way too much. So, I as well have a nice little thing that I want to show you. This is exclusive. I will soon make a video about it. But this is my new gadget that you can put on your phone. And then if you don't want people to look at your camera, you just close it. You see? Many times when I'm doing private things, I feel that my camera is looking at me. Probably it's not looking at me, but I just feel that it's looking at me. And putting some ridiculous piece of tape, you know, on your laptop or phone is not needed anymore. Thanks to the privacy. I must find a nice name for it. Let's get started. You will see a black screen for a couple of seconds. It won't be that amateuristic as before, because now I have my little privacy thingy that will bring like a sort of slide when we're gonna go from there to there. All right, are you ready? There we go. Ta-da. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Now I must turn the cam. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Ready. So there we go. Ta-ta. And now you are looking at the screen. I will remove the phone and put it in front of me so I can read all your messages. I just created a bootable USB stick. I was talking to Ruben there. Very proud of him, really. Because, yeah, I'm proud. I'm just proud. Because I was as well a big noob, eh? In GNU world. I didn't know about GNU. I started in 2012. I made the first video here on YouTube, Linux on a tablet. How to install GNU Linux on any x86 tablet. I remember, I still have that video. What did I do? I turned it off. Okay, so we're going to turn it on again, and we're going to boot up from the USB stick that I just created. And that is this USB disk, the USB flash drive, and there we go. You see that? It's just like my distro. It's like I'm opening a, something that I created. And we're going to install it to a USB stick. Oh, wait, let me start with putting in the USB stick. I'm going to install it to this USB stick here. I had, oh, look at that boot animation. Hey, that looks nice. What? Will I come again? Will and come again? Look at that. All right. All right. Nice, Ruben. Password will be channel 48. Yes, he used the same password as we use all the time. So you might think that this comes from my hand, but it's not. This comes from Ruben's hand. And oh, nice. What? Ruben, you don't joke, man. So don't show this message again. Look, what is this? Gadgets. Look at that, peeps. We have a desktop clock. This is a very nice, very, very nice desktop clock. Oh, look at that start menu. This is Windows 7, peeps. Is this Windows 7? No, it's GNU. This is all built on the GNU. Wow, dat heb je erg, erg mooi gedaan, Ruben. Ik ben ontzettend, ontzettend trots op je. He as well inserted the USB image writer and image stick formatter. I must let you know, Ruben, that this is... I as well pushed it to my previous distros, but it's proprietary software, so I'm not using this anymore. You can next time better put in start up this creator from Ubuntu. Okay, that is freeware, so you must always check if all the applications that you install are free. But it looks amazingly nice and very, very beautiful. Rhythmbox, let's see what Rhythmbox is having, how it looks. This is my favorite player. Did you add channels? No, in radio there are no channels at all. Okay, to get radio channels you can easily... Hey, we have no sound. What is this? Wi-Fi is working. We have sound, yeah. Why is this not working? Oh, there. I was just being stupid. Sorry, peeps. Once in a while I'm a little bit blunt. Okay, so yeah, if you want to start listening music out of the box, you can say add and then type... JaWorks, for instance, you know, there you go, baby, there you go. You can start downloading all sorts of non-stop reggae shows. JaWorks, JaWorks, JaWorks. JaWorks, 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 JaWorks. Every day I've got JaWorks on my mind. You must go listen this. This is really cool. Guys, hold on. I'm going to read the messages. I'm looking for System Back because we're going to start the installer. System Back. There it is, System Back. And we're going to hit System Install. This will be Windows... no, how are we going to call it? We're going to call it GNU 7. Puck. Password. Host name. Channel 48. Oh, I cannot use that. Why? What did I do? Oh, like that. Okay, next. So there we have the 32 gigabyte USB stick. That is this thing here. What I'm gonna do is just, I'm gonna unmount it. And I'm gonna delete it. Oops. Gonna select it. This one here. the drive itself, and then I'm going to say create new drive, and then we select the drive. It's selected NTFS. It must be X4, and we're going to root it as, set it as root, as mount point root, and then we give a Roger D there, and then we say transfer user configuration files, and then dang, and there we go. We're going to install the system, and I'm going to read some messages. Let me see what you all are talking there, man. Jack Reddy, hello, love your videos. Hey, thank you, man. And Logan Skak said, yes, haha, dang, Reddy. I was allowed to be proud on this work of my student. Have RAM for N900 Note 3 for iPhone. You know what it is, guys? I could do that. I can make a mod, but it will only work up to Android 9, so no Android 10. Okay, so these iOS mods we can still make, but it only goes up to Android 9. Can you guys please link up with O24? He has a channel, okay, and I want his channel to grow. All right. So whoever is tuned into this to this chat, please go to his site and subscribe to his site. Okay. So the link of the effect I wanted to do it this way. After you subscribed, you can via Ruben then get the download link. But that will be maybe a little bit too long. Just be nice whenever you go to his site to subscribe to his site. Okay, and then you just download the distro there once in a while, you know, hit notifications on. He doesn't upload so much like me, but yeah, let's say if this video is being watched good, you know, and he get 1,000 subscribers, then he can as well start doing something on YouTube, you know. He's a good guy. I know him for many years, and I'm sure he would be a very good YouTuber. But he's learning. He's as well making great music. So I just told him to make albums of his music, and then you can download that music from him as well, and then you can use it in your YouTube videos. You know, he makes music with GarageBand, and these are nice melodies that you can use in your videos. So that's kind of nice. Let me see if I have some music here on the background. I don't think so. Maybe in my other phone. Let me see. Maybe we can play some background music. I was totally not prepared to come online tonight, but I thought let's do a live show, because the previous video that I uploaded, only got 5 likes. It looks like the people are not liking the old phones that are getting Android 10 ROMs and that I make videos about it. But yeah, that's what my channel is about, you know. I have a whole lot of phones, from the Gio, the Fame, up to the S8 and other phones, iPhones, jailbreaking. We used to do, in fact, all sorts of things here on this channel. It kind of stalled on Android since I fell in love with Android, and I, you know, start doing all sorts of things on the Android. And then, you know, it only got more. I could not stop anymore. Every week I'm looking on secondhand marketplaces to find new phones, you know, secondhand phones or whatsoever. And then I see if there's development for them, how many videos there are on YouTube about that phone. And then, you know, sometimes there are no videos about that device. Not one. And then, you know, I buy that. I just go buy that device. And then I buy it. I make a video how to upgrade it to, you know, from stock to custom. And then it helps a whole lot of people. That's what I'm seeing. And then these people update their phones. and get the higher build of Android. So let's take a look a little bit. Yeah, I don't want to stress the operating system too much. It's installing now, but this is the My Computer environment. It looks like an updated Windows 7. These icons are nice, but I saw even nicer icons, Ruben, that you can get for this package. I'm not sure if you're gonna update this pack, but I have some icons for you that you could add to this system. And then, in fact, it will be, because it does not have to be, yeah, it's very close to Windows 7, but it can have some updates, huh? It can have some updates, qua look and feels. But it came very close. You did a great, great job. Amazing job. And with, of course, wine, you could even, yeah. This is all tweaked. Very nice. Looks good. We can look under the engine. File system. Oh, nice. This icon, user. I don't know. Did you put this icon in? Looks good. User, share. Looks very good. You really did your best on this. Very nice. And the operating system that this was done on is, let me see. I'm gonna do something that you cannot do in GNU. So I will have to type about, no info maybe. Info, system info, there we go. And this is Linux Mint 19 Cinnamon version 386, kernel 41520. For the rest, specifications of the device. This has been done on the Intel Core i5 with the 3210M CPU running at 2.5 gigahertz. We have 8 gigabytes of memory, and the internal is 34 gigabytes. And that is, of course, the USB stick that it's seeing. So we're installing. So how about wallpapers? Let me see. Change desktop background. Oh, that is as well nice. You see that? Ruben, you really worked hard on this thing, man. Dat heb je erg mooi gedaan. Look. You have all your favorite wallpapers that you would use in... Yeah, this is a replica, peeps. This is not really Windows. And this is, in fact, created to say goodbye to the beautiful operating system Windows that we use for many years, since Bill Gates introduced it after Vista. And Vista was a little bit too heavy for our laptops and PCs that we had at that time. Really, honestly. Most of us were, you know, swearing to, at least we would swear to always be on XP and never ever change XP. And then we got 7, and then suddenly everybody loved 7. And then we got 8, and that was not so great. And 9 was skipped, and then we got 10. Yeah. Then we got 10, Windows 10. Going back to, I most of the times love this one. This was my favorite wallpaper. I don't know which one was yours, but this was my favorite wallpaper before. When I was on Windows. Very nice. The desktop gadgets. Ongelooflijk. Je bent de echte replicateur, Mr. Ruben. Mr. Ruben is een real replicateur. Whatever that is. Very nice. Okay, we're almost there, guys. 39%. And we're going to take a look at how the system installed. Yeah, Ruben had a problem. He stalled somewhere. And then I started laughing, you know. He said, yes, I created a distro. But when I create a bootable USB, he see the boot animation. And then, boom, he get error. I say, let me see the error. So I tell him, yeah, this comes up to experience. I tell him, this comes up to experience, eh? So he did not answer me. I know he was pissed off then. When you know. Then I answered him on Facebook. He was sleeping already. So I told him the secret. What he should do to let it boot and to fix it. I also told him that it was a secret that he was not supposed to tell everybody or go make YouTube video about that. You know, certain things we cannot tell. Certain things you must find out yourself, or you must become good friends with us, you know, and then we teach you. That's how it goes. But we're not gonna put everything that we know on YouTube. That's why sometimes my videos are not that interesting, you know. I don't always come with treasures. You know, if you want to see treasures, then you must watch all my videos. This is another treasure that I bought the other day. I bought this at the Action. Soon you're gonna get a show, the Action, leukste shop van Groningen. And this is effect, yeah, my tablet PC project, Pure OS. You see that? Pure OS. And here you can go to the applications. You see that? These are all the applications. It's a kind of, yeah, tablet PC thing. And this holder that you see, this stand, is in fact a stand that you can buy at the Action, I think for €3 or so, to, you know, if you want to do gaming and so. But I don't do gaming. I found it a nice little stand to put, just put the thing, you know, and it will just stand. So, yeah. You can watch TV and so while you're working with this thing, and it works really nice. You know, I love listening to AM radio. Hey, start and turn the screen. What is he saying? Error occurred. Why? Yes. No master server. Oh, because I turned off internet probably. No, internet is on. Cancel. Start. You see that? Yeah.
Years go by, your annuity payment is still $1,500 a month. Well, this is Federal
News. This
network.
Is
senior correspondent Mike Causey.
This is live radio, eh? Radio over the air. But the antenna is not on my roof. The antenna is on somebody else's roof. And this guy, probably he lives somewhere in the United States or somewhere. And he has a big antenna on his roof. And he has a computer system with a receiver. And it's called software-defined radio. And it's connected to the internet. And, yeah, up to, depending on the bandwidth that you have to offer, you know, people can tune into that device, and then, you know, just scroll for whatever they want to listen to. We have all sorts of frequencies, LSB, that is the lower sideband, the upper sideband, CW, FM, frequency modulation, amplitude modulation. So yeah, that is kind of cool. This is really cool for these old school guys that used to have these, you know, before we didn't have computers, you know, before we had different ways to communicate. We communicated with transceivers, these kinds of devices, ham radios. And this is a ham receiver. So you can listen to live radio, but as well to amateurs talking to each other, or depending on the frequency that you're going to listen to planes and to anything. Live police in the United States. These frequencies you can just tune in and you can, yeah, it's if you have the device yourself. It's amazing. So I'm going to let this play on the background. We're almost there, 95%. Can anyone help me? What is the help that you need, my friend? Just let us know. Just type. Everybody start talking to each other. Don't be shy. This is an international room. Yeah, it doesn't matter where you come from, if you can speak good English or not good English. Just talk, okay? Just talk along. It's okay. You don't have to be afraid to talk. Because this room is international. We have people from all over the world in here, and everybody is welcome to sit and chill with us. Those that were on Pell Talk probably knew me from the Hot Cam Chat Pell Talk Room Studio 48. That was in 99 up to, I think, 2002, 2003. I had the number one rated room on that network on Pell Talk. And we had fantastic times up there. The most beautiful people from all over the world would come in and they would just chill and it would just be good. And everybody was protected. Nobody had no issues to each other. Just, yeah, I like that. That is the, yeah, I'm a moderator, you know? I'm a host. Only thing, yeah, you must have patience and just talk. Introduce yourself. Hey, I'm from the USA, and where is everybody from? I think people talk way too little these days to each other. They are scared to talk, scared that somebody might hurt them or so. Not in this room, because when I see that, I immediately, you know, take action. I don't let that happen to nobody, because I know how it is when it happens to me. But it never happened to me, because I'm always a host. I'm never a part of something. I create that something and people can be part of that. And then I make the rules, you know? My rules are always liberal, to say it this way. Friendly to everybody. No issues. Everybody's human. Everybody's blood is red. When your blood is green or blue, then we're gonna have issues with you, because then you come from outer space. Right? Or not, peeps? So who's the moderator in here? I don't see Bob. I don't see. Only, who do I see? Germany. Sasha. Hello, Sasha. Welcome. You know what we should have? I think the update of this, what we have, the chat. The chat what we have, we should be able, like on Pell Talk, YouTube, should look at Pell Talk. And what we should all have, when I open my room, when I come live, you all have the possibility to talk over your microphone. You can put up your hand and then I give you the mic and then you can talk. And if you talk nonsense, I just red dot you and kick you out of the room, you know? And in that way, we could then talk to each other. You could as well use your voice. You know how nice that is. I used to have a chat room with 200 people every day, 24/7, from all over the world. Canada, Australia, United States, Netherlands, India, Pakistan. I don't know where they all came from, man. Everywhere. And everyone was nice to each other. Look, there we are. Okay, sometimes they were not nice, you know, but then we had to do some bouncing. I had some admins in the room, you know, and we would just kick people out, man. So we're gonna just reboot. And there we go. Ching. What? So no, I must wait. Hold on. I must hit F9. No. I must hit F9, because now we're gonna boot from the SanDisk drive that we just installed. I remove the USB stick, and there is the SanDisk, and there we go. Are you ready? And there we go. We can boot Ubuntu. The other partitions of Ubuntu, these are on the drive, on the internal of this laptop. So that's why you see them. I'm gonna turn off the light a little bit. Later, I have kids and take care of. Enjoy your video. Who is that? Logan, Logan Skaggs. Thank you very, very much. God bless and stay well, my friend. And last name, hello, welcome to the room. And Bob is in the house. Hello, Bob. I was calling for you already just now. I see that you're in the house. Of course, you are still admin. And there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, I also introduce you to Bob. Bob is from Chicago, right, Bob? And the password, guys, is the password that I just created. For the live, that will be, of course, channel 48. Even though this distro was not created by me. Good to see you there, Bob. How are you? How is the family doing? Everything okay there with you, bro? God bless, man. Download problem. I9300. Why? Why do you have download problem? There was a download problem today. Okay, the system is booted up. As you can see, we offer wallpaper choice, and yeah, that is a little bit to protest against. It's nonsense, but you have wallpaper choice, and the wallpapers you will find in Windows 7. It's busy. It's a little bit busy at this point. Do you select install all setting? Yeah, of course. Of course I did. Of course I did. But hey, that is not, it's not a problem at all. Because there are your wallpapers. You see that? The people have wallpaper choice. They can choose whatever they want to. You know, we're not gonna push anything to the people. They get a black screen. And then they can go ahead and put the picture maybe from their children or from their self or maybe from his car. You don't know what, you know, what people want to look at. The people have wallpaper choice, man. They can choose their self. We cannot choose for them. We like to do that, but we should not do that too often. People have their own wills and their own choices. And you should leave that for the people. It's very important. But you can never, ever, ever make such a big change in an operating system the way Microsoft did. The way Microsoft did it was so radical that even an Apple user would run away. If Apple would ever do that to the Mac operating system, if they would, for instance, that little Apple that is there in the corner for, I think, for the last 30 years, if they would dare to put take away that Apple. Oh my God, they would sue Apple. I don't know what would happen. They would get crazy. You know, Apple users, they don't like changes too much. Apple is doing it. After Snow Leopard. In Snow Leopard, you know, certain things are very important to people. For instance, to me, it's very important when I open my home folder that I can see the empty space there, the space that I still have left on my drive here. But when you're gonna hide it away, and in Apple world, you know, they start hiding that away since Lion. So if you come from Snow Leopard and you upgrade to Lion, then suddenly that is gone. And then suddenly you're dealing with, how you call these things? A scroll bar that is hiding. So you're trying to get it and then it hides away again. So you're trying to get it, and then it hides away again. So you're getting all confused. You're like, where is my blood clot? Scroll by, you know? Why is the thing playing hide and seek on me? And it's playing hide and seek on you because you must probably buy a new Mac. You know, I'm talking about this thing here. It was in Mac. They think it's nice to hide it away. It's not nice to hide it away, man. People want to see their scroll bar. Don't hide nothing away. But these little changes that Ruben brought to Windows 7, for instance, the taskbar, it looks updated in some way. The colors, it looks a little bit different. This looks like an updated Windows 7. Oh, sorry for that. Windows 7 skin, you know, and it looks really, really, really good. So I'm gonna give 5 stars to this operating system, just because it's just completely perfect the way I see it. It's running on Linux Mint. And Linux Mint is a good operating system, a very good operating system. You have System Back installed. You have a very easy way to format any USB drive. Just right mouse click it, and then you're gonna find the format option, just like Windows in there. That is very, very handy. I miss that most of the times in Ubuntu. But then I installed Gparted. Let me see, is Gparted installed? Gparted is installed. Very well done, Ruben. That is very good of you to put Gparted. Did I forget my password? Okay, my password is not working anymore, Ruben. Ruben, my password. Sudo. Wait, hold on. Let me see. Sudo su. Oh, my numlock was on. I was like, oh, that is crazy. No, yeah. Still not good. Okay, so yeah. What you can do when this happens to you is just do a restart. The sounds must be set on. In the settings. And then you're gonna hear the shutdown sounds as well. There we go, nice. Lovely. Lovely. F9. Boot. Nice operating system. Now the next step for you, Ruben, is to install to get Android into the system, eh? We can do that. Is this 64-bit? I thought you select transfer data files, all the sounds and wallpapers. Yeah, that is a tricky thing. You put the wallpapers in pictures, that is another thing that we must talk about. I will teach you that as well soon. Hey, ha! What happened to my blood clot password? Ruben, I cannot log in anymore. I'm locked out.
So Hey, Ruben. I'm locked out. What happened? What did we do? We logged into the system. In fact, we did not do anything. Change wallpapers, change... Huh? Maybe we got hacked. Hey, Ruben. Maybe the hacker is in the chat room right now. And he's laughing his ass off. No, no caps lock. No caps lock, no num lock. I'm just locked out. This is crazy. Let me think. This is almost unbelievable. No. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, we just had this is crazy. This is helemaal eventjes niet te flitsen. Hier snap ik helemaal geen fluit van. That means I don't understand a whistle about this. What is happening now? So let me see what we can do about it. This is very... very apart. Let's see what the Kipasa. I'm listening to AM radio. How many people in the world are still listening to AM radio? Via a computer where they can listen to high quality music. Okay. So yeah. When you finish, can you please help me? Problem. Okay, let me read the problems. What is the problem, my friend? Tell me your problems. Tell me your problems. As long as you don't ask me money, then it's all good. You can ask me everything except money. let me see. Will Android 10 work on S8 G950FD? I think yes, and if not, if it does not install, then it will not install. It will not break your system. Do you already have a custom ROM? What custom ROM are you using, by the way? And I'm talking to Syed Baba. And maybe password channel 48. No, I made new password when we installed it. Let me see. Abul Khan, when you finish, can you please help me for my problem on S8? So, hey, what's up, Mati? Welcome to the room. Call me. Hey, bro, you cannot call me now, man. I'm in the middle of a thing now, man. You're gonna kill my recording, bro. Matty is calling me. Hey, Matty, I just installed the Linux system and the thing password changed. Oh, wait a minute. I have no idea what is happening. It's not working anymore. Suddenly, I cannot log into the system anymore. This is crazy. I don't know what happened. I think maybe Ruben is playing a trick on us here. Ruben, are you hacking me, man? No, he's not. He would not even know how to do that. So, yeah. Let me see. I need to fix that. But meanwhile, I'm just gonna boot from the Philips again. Let me see how to do that. I have special codes in my phone. As well, I don't know everything out of my head. So there you are. Hello, all newcomers. Welcome to the room. What you're looking at is Windows 7 replica. It's not Windows 7, okay? It's GNU. Even though it's making these sounds, and this is as well a tribute to, I think, the operating system that most people in the world used for many years, okay? And this was created by my student Ruben, and he learned how to create distros here on Channel 48. I'm very proud of him. He's as well in the room. He's one of the administrators together with Bob and with Matty. So just talk to each other, say hello, and welcome to Channel 48 Live. So we just did the installing, but something went wrong. I did something wrong. I don't know what I did. And for the newcomers that just came inside, we see that the room, the viewers are coming in. So yeah, we're gonna do it just one more time. It's all good. This is just a live show. We're gonna look for a system back. And this time I will not forget my password. I make password, but I forget. It's because of this live show, you know? So, okay, we're gonna call the system GNU. GNU 7. Yeah, are you there? Are we still recording? Yes. Okay, GNU 7. Username will be GNU. GNU 7 as well. New user password will be... Okay, home. Next. This is the USB stick that I'm gonna install it to. I'm gonna unmount it first, and I'm gonna just select the X4. Gonna mount it as root, X4, and format is selected. Transfer user configuration files. Do you see that? I'm selecting that, Ruben. Can you see it? It's all a little bit lower. Let me see if I can make it a little bit lighter here. Looks like Okay, Matty, don't call me again, huh? Otherwise my video goes away, bro. All right, so now we can hit next, and I'm just gonna hit start. All right, so now I'm gonna answer some questions. If you have some questions, you can ask them now while we're installing. Let me see. Okay. Also, it makes sounds if you put a USB and change the volume. Okay, that is very nice. I did not test that yet. I did not put no USB in yet. So, whoever has questions about any phone or ROM that I, you know, make videos about, just shoot. Just ask along. Say hello to the group. Introduce yourself, wherever you're from. You know, people want to be all sort. People want to be anonymous in all sorts of ways these days. So they don't want to say where they're from. But really, it doesn't hurt if you tell people where you're from. I'm from Holland. From Groningen. Yep. I'm from Groningen. They say Groningen is the happiest city from Europe. And I believe it. I'm always happy in this city. I never have stress. I live in a beautiful environment with a park around me, with trees, birds that are, you know, whistling when I wake up in the morning. So Groningen is a nice city. And those that just came in, if you're wondering what I'm listening to the AM radio. This phone that you're seeing, I'm going to make a review about it very soon. Is the G531F, and it's a phone that has a Marvel chip, and it cannot be updated to Android 7 because Marvel had to do all sorts of tweaks to make their Marvel chip run on AOSP. They had to modify AOSP sources really heavily, and they don't want to tell the developers what sources and what they did. So the developers stalled at Android 6. They cannot continue. And that's how these companies are. Eh? These are big companies. And then, yeah, in fact, they bring proprietary into open source. And then a phone like this, it ends. There will be no more development for that. So I'm going to make a video for the CEO of Marvel. And then I'm going to ask him in the name of all the developers that they release all these things that they did to the sources and that they give this information free. And then suddenly this phone will get Android 10 as well, if that happens. But if that does not happen, if Marvel refuse to give us that information, then we can forget it. And they have all the right to do so, eh? We cannot go to judge and say, we're gonna sue you, Marvel. No, you cannot. It's proprietary and they can do whatever they wish. And that is a pity. So that means if somebody is holding back information on a certain part, then suddenly the complete development for the complete Android and device stalled. Then suddenly, nothing happens anymore. And that's so unfair. I mean, like, such a beautiful device, the Galaxy Grand Prime. Look at this thing. It's beautiful. A lovely phone. You tell me this phone is not good? But it has the wrong chips. It has the wrong chips. A phone that will get Android 10 very soon as well. That is this phone. Chrono Monochrome will bring this phone to Android 10. This is the Note 2. At this moment we have development by Comico and by Chrono. But this phone will get updated. The Note 7, the Note 2, the 7100. And that's thanks to the fantastic chips that were used in this device, and thanks to, you know, companies that are telling the developers whatever the crap they did. Only there at Marvel they seem to have issues. We have these companies, you know. Yes, battery is a little bit low, but I can still show it really fast to the people. This is Pocket PC number 2. This very, very lovely Pocket PC. This will come out somewhere in 2020. I will release somewhat. Here you can as well use a dark theme. We have dark theme as well. You see that? Nicer. Lovelier. What you say? You don't see these kinds of launchers. And then you can lock the screen and then nothing happens anymore. You see that? Lovely, lovely, lovely. Nice, huh? So this will as well come soon. And then you can download it. This will come to devices that won't get no updates anymore. That are stuck on some ROM because no more development, or devices too old, or, you know, companies hold back information for the developers. So that's the whole thing. All right, we're installing again, my man, and we're chilling a little bit here with the people. But hey, let me know, what do you think? Would it not be a good idea if YouTube would bring in a section into this chat with all the names of you guys on the left and on the right, and that you can then put up your hand, and that you can then, I can then give you the microphone, and then you can broadcast as well from where you are, and then you can talk live to the chat room, you know, and then everybody in the chat room can hear you talking, and then after that you give the mic to somebody else, you know, and then we talk like that to each other. Would that not be cool? I think I must talk to Susan. We must talk to Susan, give her inspiration to do that, because Susan did a lot of good things already, yeah, here on YouTube. Many people are complaining about this, that, so, but she fixed many things already. Good things. Good things. Especially for creators. So I'm very happy with her. Yeah, I see some people leave already. I don't care. Susan is all to me here on YouTube. If it goes good with her, it goes good with us. And Susan is as well from July, eh? I'm as well from July. So I feel her. I can feel her. July people are special people. People that are born in the month July, these are very special people. These are people with feeling. So, what are we talking about in the chat room? Bob, tell me something. How is life in Chicago? How is everybody there in Chicago doing? How's the family? It's okay. I have my IME and baseband. You got a lot of snow. I'm jealous, man. I'm jealous. We don't have no snow. We only had some storm by the name of Kiara. And then we have another one coming. That is Dave. Or Dave came right after Kiara. These guys are...
they are following the leader, you know. Everything America does, they want to do too. America give names to storms. Suddenly, Europe want to give names to storms too. They are not original. Come with something original. Why should a storm have a name? A storm is a storm.
Yes, but then you know how strong the storm is by the name.
No storm is the same. A storm can never be the same like the one before. So you can call it Kiara, or you can call it Dave, or you can call it any name. It will never be the same. So then you can as well not give it a name. We're gonna get a heavy storm, ladies and gentlemen. Start closing your windows with wooden, with wood, etc. And you know, or evacuate the people. But they're making a complete show around the thing, man. Kiara. Nonsense. Kiara. Cape Town. Oh, you're from Cape Town? Cape Town is Africa, right? Where is Cape Town? Is it Cape Town in Africa? Because we have some songs, some reggae songs going, talking about Cape Town. Where's Cape Town? Tell me where Cape Town is, because I know I heard that name very often. I think it's somewhere in Africa. Or not? South Africa. Yeah, man. I tell you, South Africa, don't press a man. You got to know where you're coming from. You know that song? South Africa, don't press a man. You better go away. That song was a great hit. Ruud Gullit, our soccer player, very popular soccer player from the Netherlands, he used to sing in that clip, South Africa, don't press a man. You got to know where you're coming from. Yep. Zimbabwe. So people, welcome to the room. You're at the live chat. What are we doing? Yeah, we're installing Windows 7 replica that you can get from my brother called O24, Ruben. I think he posted a link somewhere here to his channel. Just find his name in the chat, Ruben, and click his name, go to his channel, and go ahead and just... Your accent sound like people from Cape Town. Oh, I do? Well, then, it could be. I'm from Suriname, South America. And there we as well speak Dutch, but we speak with a different accent. And then we come to Holland, and then, yeah, in fact, in Holland, the people are as well talking with a different accent. But if you're gonna talk with that accent as a Surinamese living in Holland, I think it looks kinda a little bit too much, you know? So that's why I always kept my own kinda accent, and yeah. That's why it is the way it is. Want we kunnen natuurlijk ook als Nederlander gaan praten, maar ja weet je, dat vind ik niet echt passen bij mij, hè? Ik wil gewoon echt mijn eigen accent behouden. En ja, Nederlands is Nederlands. Je verstaat het of je verstaat het niet. You know, English is English. You understand it or you don't understand it. En ja, accent is, I mean, like, I cannot talk like somebody that comes from Texas. It would be very strange if you would hear me talking with such an accent. And then, you know, my location is Holland. I'm a Dutchman. And then I talk like an Englishman or like... you know, you have these Dutch people. When they speak English, they really speak with that accent, you know, the right accent. You would swear that it's somebody from London or somebody from the United States.
And I think that is a little bit too much for me. I don't want to do that. Otherwise, I feel like I'm losing my identity, you know? I like to keep my identity. I like to be me. So yeah, if it sounds like a South African accent, or maybe some other accent from Russia, it's all good to me. Right? So who's in the room? Let me see. Not really, no. February, blah, 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 blah. Okay. So yeah, I see you guys are not talking so very much. We're looking at the installing. I'm installing it for the second time. I forgot my password. I could not log in to the system that I installed just now. I was talking so much with the room that I probably just forgot my password. And so I thought it would be wise to install it again. I think I will not put this live show up. Okay, so those that saw the installing will see the installing, because this will be a ridiculous show to put up. We're talking about so many different things. This is just a live chat. But I have a nice little video, and I will be able to upload that one, and then the people can as well see it with the right links where you can go to download it and to test it out. It's not made by me. Once again, it's not made by me. This was made by Ruben. And he did it on Linux Mint. So the operating system is Linux Mint 19. It only looks like Windows 7. All right. And it was done as a tribute to Windows 7. To remember them forever. Just like how I did with all the other builds, like Windows 95 and all of them. I made them in Linux, in GNU. Windows 2000, XP, all the expired versions. And now Windows 7 is expired. So Windows 7 as well gets a version. And I think this one is very well done. I would not do it even better. So I think Ruben did it very, very nice. So it would be nice if link problem with i9300. Okay, let me see what that is. Because I myself had a problem with downloading from, let me see, Android 10. Samsung S3 i9300. Okay, there it is. Android 10 Neo i9300. This video is from the 5th of February. Let's go there. Yeah. And then we're gonna go to my channel. We go to my videos. And this should be the S3 video. Yeah. And here in show more, we go to the developers forum. Yeah, Chrono Monochrome. And then you go here to Android File Host, and here is the link. You see? Here is the link. And then you can download this one here from the 8th of February. And then start download. Hey, No mirrors found. That is because too many people are downloading this now. Too many people are downloading this now. There are too many people downloading. You must just keep trying. You must keep trying. Until it's going to show you some mirrors. No mirrors. Oops. No mirrors found. Too many people are downloading it now. Maybe somebody else as well made a video, you know, and let's look on YouTube how many videos there are about Android 10, Samsung S3i9300. Let me see who created videos. That is me. Nobody. Nobody, only me. Nobody show Android 10 on YouTube. On S3. Only me. You see that? But what I find strange, I don't see my latest video. This one. I don't see that one. Where is that one? Oh, here it is. That's what I thought. I think many people are downloading it. I don't know. So I will ask Chrono if he can as well put it on his Google Drive. Because I cannot do that. I must ask him first. You see? So I will ask him because these guys, they cannot deliver it anymore. These guys, they need help. Android file host need help. Today as well, I was downloading the ROM for the S2. You see, it's searching for mirrors. It should give two mirrors, Canada and... Canada and United States, Washington. There's something wrong with them. You must wait, guys. It's not our fault. Okay, the ROM is still there, but it's just gone for now because these guys, they cannot host whatever they are surfing there. All right, so we're gonna boot from the SanDisk drive now, and we're gonna boot into GNU 7. Je bent er nog steeds, jongen. YouTube has to update it, I think. Wat moet YouTube updaten? Wat moeten ze precies updaten? Oké, goed zo. Kun je af en toe even die link naar jouw dingen posten? Of even een link naar je kanaal? Guys, can you please go to the channel of O24? And up there you're gonna find the subscribe button. Hit the subscribe button and you will get the link to test out this operating system. I did not forget my password now. So... we're gonna get into the Cinnamon desktop, and we just logged in. I'm gonna bring it a little bit closer, and this light is irritating me. We don't need all that light, man. Too much light is not good. So, here, And there, yeah, look at that. So I already said it for those that just came in. Welcome to the live broadcast. You see a black wallpaper. We have browser choice. You can go ahead and change background from here, but I would not do that. What I would do if I was you is just go to the home folder, so you can start looking at the operating system. This is your home folder, and up here you have your pictures. Yeah, and here you're gonna find a folder called Windows 7, and now you can go ahead and choose the wallpaper that you want to use. Okay, my favorite one is this wallpaper, and then I'm just gonna set it to wallpaper, and then boom, you see, we have a nice wallpaper. Okay, so yeah, this is not Windows 7 for whoever, you know, is seeing this now. Guys, this is a tribute to Windows 7, tribute to Microsoft for their great work and the amazing time that we had under Windows. And unfortunately, that is not the case anymore. We don't have Windows 7 anymore. It's over now. And I just hope that those that are still so in love with Windows 7 that they can get over it. Okay, and this is not some alternative, but this is a souvenir. And if you would like to test it around or run it on top of your Windows 7 system, I think then you can as well, you know, kind of learn about how to get around. But I don't think you have to learn a whole lot. It shows it all. Yeah, it's very simple. It's just like Windows. So let's check out the internet. I'm connected with a cable. Let's check out plugins, add-ons, extensions. He did not install any extensions, so yeah, that is as well nice. You can O24 weet wat je zegt over die. Je bent administrator, hè? Dus weet wat je zegt, hè? Over Windows. Wees maar niet te hard tegen hun. Ze hebben het dan moeilijk genoeg. So what I was saying about add-ons. I'm gonna install an add-on because my eyes are hurting me a bit of the white thingy. So I just type dark. So now you're gonna learn how to install add-ons if you did not know it already. I'm gonna go for this one, dark mode. I'm gonna add it. Okay. So now when I'm gonna go to Google, my Google will be nice and dark. See that? So in add-ons manager, there are many things that I can install, but in fact, yeah, plugins is something personal, you know. I in fact don't want to really install all sorts of plugins now, but dark mode is one of them. Another one is to bring functionality of speech to the browser. Is you type speech and then you look for the speech software from Haipan. They put it all the way here down. Don't worry about it. It's the best. And then you add it to Firefox. Add. Okay. And then you open it. And then you're gonna see, cannot read aloud this website. Don't worry about it. Hit the little wheel. Auto select. And then go ahead and find the scroll bar. I cannot even find it here. Standard voices. You must scroll with the, how you say, with pijltje, with your keyboard. And you need Google Translate. That is what you need. All the other voices will not work, okay? So you need Google Translate. I'm gonna put it on Dutch, okay? Because I'm Dutch. But you could put it on any language you wish. And now I have a nice female voice.
Barack Hussein Obama, geboren op 4 augustus 1961, is een Amerikaanse politicus.
A
Barack Hussein Obama, geboren op 4 augustus 1961. Barack Hussein Obama, geboren op 4 augustus 1961, is een Amerikaanse politicus die van 20 jaar.
What do we learn from this? What do we learn from this speech reader? We learn that this guy did not update his standard message about President Obama. To him, to this guy, Obama is still the president. He never updated that he updated his application, but he never updated his message. Because now he should talk about Donald Trump. Okay, so what extension can we take more? Yeah, another one that you can take. No, I don't want to show you guys all these things, man. You must find out yourself. Okay, there are whole lots of plugins. I showed you two. These two will bring good functionality to your system. And up here, the news. You know, you can sit back now in the morning. And then, hey, bro, what are you doing, man? What's wrong with you, man? This thing works the best with Google Chrome. This application. Then the auto selection works good. But I just put you on this stuff. How are you embarrassing me in front of the people?
Aanklagers in zaak tegen oud-adviseur Trump stappen op na tweet van president. Alle aanklagers in de strafzaak tegen een oud-adviseur.
Okay, you see? So now we brought that functionality to this system. A browser is an important thing, huh? I'm gonna show you one more plugin. This is also a cool plugin. Just type radio. Radio. Look at that. This one here, World Radio. It's amazing. You just add it. Okay. And then here on top, you see, your radio is now, all your add-ons are now on top there. Huh? I'm not sure if you can see it. I'm gonna put the camera a little bit better. You see? And now you can hit the radio. And now you have a world radio, a world. Look at that. Cuba, Haiti, USA, Puerto Rico, Jamaica. Hey, Jamaica. Yeah, man. Yeah. Free music.
We always fall behind.
Not all of them play. Jam rock radio. Jar radio, blood clot. Yeah. Big belly man, man. Okay, so but my favorite is, of course, Suriname is as well in the list. That's why I like it. You see Suriname immediately. Immediately you see Suriname here. I'm like, hey, I love this app, you know? And then here you can listen to Radio Apinti, the happy station. These guys, they play great music all the time. This is the best station from, well, let me not say nothing because otherwise other stations will get mad. But they are very good station. I listen to them very often. So yeah, these are the plugins that I have for you, that I added to the system, you see? So now you have a good system that is installed on USB. We have Bleach Bit is a cleaning tool. Not that we made so much mess, but I can show it. Damn it. Hold on. There we go. Is it booting? It's not starting. Let me see one more time. Oh, there it is. Patience, Perk, patience. Okay, everything is nicely selected the way it should. Very well done, Ruben. And we're just gonna hit delete, and it's gonna do a cleanup. Ja, wachtwoord is gewerkt hoor. Dat is goed te gaan. We just cleaned 10 megabytes, but this could easily be 2-3 gigabytes after a while of being on the internet and you know, doing stuff. It's gonna really grow. Alrighty. So let's see how YouTube works. Oh yeah. One more thing, Ruben, next time, make sure to as well hit the bookmarks toolbar. This one can be deleted. This one can as well be deleted. And then, let's see if this all works. Access denied. Did you see that? Access denied, peeps. These pieces of crap. Sorry, I had to. I'm sorry for that. So we cannot watch that anymore. Let me see. If this is working, the stream is offline. Oh my goodness. Yeah, what can I say? Sometimes these servers are open and sometimes they are closed. Gladly, I have an app on my Android device. Let's install Android into this thing. It's 32-bit, eh? Ah, okay. Let's install Android into this. You know what we're gonna install? We're gonna go ahead and install CyanogenMod. Android x86. Let's go to Android x86. Let's download from OSDN, or maybe I need the other one. No, I don't want this. I want old version. Yeah. Or FOSHub. FOSHub maybe. Yes. Damn. Yeah, of course we could go for Android 9. Of course. Of course we could. But I wanted to show something special, you know? Of course we can go for Android 9. 705 megabytes. Hey, they changed the site a bit, huh? Looking for pre-release. What kind of pre-release? Oh, what is this? I never saw this before. All right. So I want that effect. Let's go to this site here. The Q branch is ready for developers. So whoever wants to develop Android x86 can go ahead and do that. More. Let me see. CM13. We as well have Remix OS. I'm gonna go for CM13. The first stable release of CM13. Let's get that one. And we need the RPM file, the RPM. We need the 32-bit RPM, 622 megabytes. Save. Yeah, there's something wrong with Android file host, and that's why it's not all working too good. Okay. So let's prepare the computer for these kinds of things. Sudo apt get install alien. Sudo apt get update. Oops, sorry. Okay, sudo apt get update, and then sudo apt get install. Oh, this will not work, Ruben. You use Linux Mint. I'm gonna show you something stupid from Linux Mint. Why I'm not using Linux Mint anymore. Now you're gonna see why, okay? Sudo apt-get install alien. Alien. Yes. I'm gonna show you why I'm always using original Ubuntu and not Linux Mint anymore for my distros, because on Linux Mint I cannot make Droid distros. In some way it gets it wrong with the grub. I can only do this in with Ubuntu. That's why I'm always using Ubuntu. Now, sudo apt get kemu. Okay, kemu is sudo apt get install kemu. Kemu is a virtualization tool that will let these kinds of laptops and computers with virtualization built in run the Android straight from out the desktop in a little window. Then you're gonna have GNU and Android in one. And for the poor people, the system alien will create a dual boot, so you can as well boot into Android. You understand? So at the beginning, when you're gonna boot up the computer, you can say, I don't want to boot up with Linux, but I want to boot up with Android. And then you just select Android. It will be in the list. But Linux Mint is getting it wrong. And that is what I'm gonna show to you live on cam. Probably I'm gonna leave this video up. still showing some things here that we can learn from why it's not happening. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go into my home folder. I'm going to create a new folder. And I'm going to call the folder, rename, Android. Alrighty, there it is. To make the folder recognizable, I will I also have no search function here. Let me see. I will use this icon. Okay, with that lock on it. So we're gonna open it, and the file that we just downloaded, this one here, gonna put it on the desktop, and we're gonna put it into the Android folder. Now we're gonna open the terminal here, open in terminal, and now we're gonna say sudo, and then alien, apostrophe, psi, can you read that? Yeah, and then space, and then the exact name of this package, rename. The exact name of the package. So I hit rename and then select the name, and then, you know, I copy that and I put it in there, and I'm gonna hit enter, password. And there we go. And then it's gonna stand on there for a while. But in fact, there is activity going on. You see that here? It's working now. You see that little lock on that folder there? It's busy with, with implementing Android now into the system. But the problem is that that Linux Mint will not get it right at the boot. It will just not get it right. I wasted so much time on this already in the past. Built my complete system, and then I want to push Android in, and boom. Even kijken, amigo, hello, amigo, how are you? Nee, hij deed het wel. Ja, hij deed het hoor. Wachtwoord doet het. Nee, geen probleem. So, this might take a little, depending on the speed of your processor. But the coolest is, I'm doing this all from off this USB stick. So this complete operating system is installed on the USB stick. You see that? So when I gonna remove that USB stick and I come to your house, I say, hey, can I lend your computer? I have my own operating system with me, and I stick it into your laptop or computer, and I boot from the stick, then this will pop up. So this is as well portable. This installation that I did was a portable installation. It can run on any x86 system, 32-bit or 64-bit. And that is thanks to the wise decision to use a 32-bit system. Not sure if this system has PAE. And if it has PAE, then it will be, even though it's 32-bit, use the complete 8 gigabytes and not only 3.5 like Windows. And here you can see memory 7.8 gigabyte. Yeah, so this is a PAE system. So that means even though this is a 32-bit, you know, the fully 8 gigabyte is being used from the internal memory. So 32-bit is not always bad, Many people, they always want 64-bit, 64-bit, 32-bit sometimes is better for your system. It supports more devices, and it's very fast. Exactly. 32-bit systems, yeah, they want to get rid of it because, yeah. If the people, if they learn how good these devices are, then in fact they will never sell them, just like me. My old quad-core computer running 3 flight simulators. I don't want to update it. I don't need to update it because it's doing everything for me already. Because I installed the right software. I was not pushed by nothing to make decisions to, you know, that would cost me a whole lot of money and would let me throw away good hardware. I don't want to throw away good hardware. For what? If the computer works good, why should I upgrade it? Faster to do what? What should it do faster? It's already doing my thing. It's cool. If I'm going to update, it's going to be for Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. I might update for them. Only for that simulation game. When it comes out, I will buy it. You know? And then I'm going to install it, my man. And then, my friends, we're going to make flights all over the place. All over the world we're going to go to. I'm going to show you Suriname, like how it is for real. Because these guys are working with satellite maps. It's so amazing. And you know, in 2015, I was kind of pissed off on Microsoft, eh? Because they were not doing nothing. So then, I made a demo, Microsoft, I called it Microsoft Flight Simulator Z, I called it. And of course you will not see it, because it's a very old video, but it should be somewhere. Should be here. Microsoft Flights. Ah, I saw it. Where is it? Oh boy. This thing is not even popping up. This is terrible. I'm the only one that created that in the whole world and it's not popping up. Shame on you, Google. There you go. This was my Microsoft Flight Simulator 2015. I created this. This was my protest for Microsoft. I wanted them to go back to the development, so I made this video. I called it Leaked Flight Simulator Z, Airport Eelde, Groningen. You see that? And there's a plane coming. You cannot see it yet, but it's coming. Look, there it comes. You see it? Microsoft unofficial. And now, after 5 years, oh my God, look at me with my bald head. At that time, I shaved my head all the time. Kale knikken, zeg hey. Oh my goodness. I look so strange at that time. With my bald head. No, I'm not shaving my head anymore for now. I'm done with that.
At that time I was gangster, you know, gangster boy. Always shave my head, DJ Puck. Okay, so let's take a look at that thing. You see? What did it say? No such file. Bootgrubcustom.cfg. No such file. This blah, blah, blah nonsense message I get from, you know, from these guys. So now I'm going to type sudo, because I just got the idea. Update grub. Not grub. Sudo. Update grip. Oh no, how do you do that? Sudo. Grip 2 maybe? How do we update grip again? I forgot. Damn, I don't know everything. But it's very simple, then you just go to, you know, how to update grub in Ubuntu, and then it's gonna tell you exactly how to do that. Sudo update grub. Oh, I forgot the little line, you stupid. So it's sudo. And then update, and then apostrophe grub. You see, if you forget the apostrophe, this thing won't work for you, man. A little apostrophe. Found Ubuntu. It's not finding Android. Hi. Let's take a look. Sudo reboot. So, hey, next time, your next distro that you're going to create, O24, I want you to create this distro again. But I want you to do it on Ubuntu. Okay? You must do it on Ubuntu. And you must do it from off the 60, the net installer. So don't you, or you can as well use Ubuntu with, but when you're going to use the net installer, then you can install just Cinnamon. Only Cinnamon as the desktop. You don't install no server. So in the part where you're going to get to software, you're just going to skip that. You're just going to hit enter. And then you're going to get to the grub fixing part. And then in fact, it's done. And then it's gonna boot up, and then it's gonna bring you to a terminal screen. And from there, you install Cinnamon. You understand? And Cinnamon will come with all his little tools, including the, I think you will as well have to install a login window, or maybe Cinnamon will fix the greeter, will as well add the greeter. X greeter or so, I'm not sure. Otherwise, it will add a greeter, I'm sure it will. And then, you know, you're gonna boot into a Cinnamon that is completely empty. No calculator, no nothing in it. And from there you start building. Then you have less trash. Okay, so we're gonna start from the SanDisk. And now Android should be in this list, you see? But it's not coming. That's because of Linux Mint. Linux Mint did something with the boot. I don't know what they did, really, for real. I don't know. But I can never, ever, only in version 17 I could do it. But then in version 18 it was taken away. And not, forget about 19 and even 20. It will just not work. So I don't know why that is. And why Linux Mint distros are always giving me this stupid problem.
Because now I cannot just, I just cannot install my Android. It doesn't really matter, you know, but I just wanted to show you. If this was Ubuntu, then the Android would be there and you would be fine. There's as well Wine installed, eh? Wine. And a cool tool for DJs, for instance, I'm not sure if you can still find it. That is all proprietary, so what I'm going to show you now is proprietary. And I don't make distros that come that way anymore. I make only free distros. Okay, but Virtual DJ 7 free download. Okay, and now you must look good. Don't go to virtualdj.com. These guys, they remove their download link. This one, Uptown, could have it. This one, yeah, 34 megabytes. That's correct. All right, this is cool, safe. Another cool software is Cool Edit Pro 2.1 download. Cool Edit Pro 2.1. Let me see the size, 2.9 megabyte, that is not correct. This is a fake site, it's rubbish. phpnuke.org. I don't know, I don't trust it. 2 megabytes is not 2 megabytes. Let me go to TechSpot. Okay, there it is already. It's 16 megabytes. That's correct. And it's called Sept Setup. Okay, so now we have the virtual DJ. We can click it. And we can install it. We're going to do custom install because there's spyware in here. Next. You see the spyware here? That is when companies, when they remove a good tool from their website and they're gonna just not deliver that tool anymore, you know, then other people take that tool and they make another installer and they start pimping off something that is free. But by turning this off, you're not installing any of that. Okay, it's important to know. These things we don't have in GNU world. You know, these tricky things. Don't show again. And there you go. New version. No. No new version. Don't let it get you. Let's see if I have some music. I should have some music. Wait, hold on. Users. GNU 7. Damn, this is a little bit strange. This, I'm just gonna go here. Oh no, this is not my computer. This is brand new installed, then I must go here. This is my other system, home, Lindroid, and then downloads. And up here we should have some MP3. Okay, let's just put them in my music. Akido. Put them in. This is crazy music, man. I don't know what to do with that. But yeah, we could install a DJ mix player. And we're doing that. Yeah, for some people might think this is Windows. This is not Windows. This is happening on the GNU. GNU Linux. And we're installing Cool Edit, a very popular software to make recordings, to make mixes, to make all sorts of things. And I as well have another tool that I want to test, but in fact, I can better not do that. Because if it breaks things, then zijn we nog verder van huis. So how is it going here? 8 viewers. Are we still having fun? Everybody still feeling happy in the house? You're enjoying the show? At least it's not a show. It's just a chill house. This is chill house. With my brothers Bob. And with Matty. And with O24. And maybe some others as well. Chilling with some news on the background that is being broadcast via some AM live stream, thanks to Software Defined Radio. So that is very nice. Listening to the radio is still different than listening to some perfect streaming station, you know, with high quality sound. It's different. The vibration is different. Just hit yes here, and up here you can say keep evaluating. Let's see if the sounds were found good. What you say, peeps? All happening on the GNU. Yeah, well, this is all happening on the GNU. Yeah, you know, some people say Linux is, yeah, only for nerds and so. It's not true, eh? It's not true. Linux, I think, every school should teach their students at least 1 hour per week about GNU. That the students get to make a project just like Ruben did. You know, make a distro. Maybe they can make a distro for some company. And that they get sponsored by that company. There are many ways. There are many ways. Yeah. But now its effect, you must see it this way. We learned, of course, as well from Windows. I learned from all the operating systems I learned. And I learned the most
from Apple. I just loved Apple. I love the art of Apple. I loved everything about Apple. But as well, it was a hate-love relationship because in Apple world, there was not so much I could do. You know, you could jailbreak and yeah, at a certain moment I created a Hackintosh. That was my first Mac. Now I have real Macs, you know, but I mean, at that time, I didn't have the intention or even the cash to buy a Mac, you know? And I was like, hey, if we can build one, it's gonna be even more fun. So then I, at a certain moment, built my own Mac on the some Hackintosh build from iAtkos. I never forget that name, iAtkos. S3, that was my build that I installed successfully to my e-machine. After trying so many times and failing so many times, I did not understand the hardware. And later, little by little, I start understanding. I was like, I must install this text and I must select this and that. And then I learned. And then suddenly I understood it. I knew what to select and how to fix things at a certain moment. If I would boot into the desktop and we would have no sound, how to fix the sound, you know? Or how to fix the mouse and the keyboard. You could do that with Apple Kex, but there was as well this other Kex, what is it called again? I forgot this, you know, when you don't do these things for a long time, then you forget. So it's very important that we as well do these projects. Maybe we should make a schedule on Monday, you know, Mac, Tuesday, Windows, Wednesday, Android. You know, every day another OS, another, you know, thing. But yeah, then again, I might miss Android 10 builds that come out that I want to show, you know. Sometimes they are being released and then the same day I want to show it because then the item is hot. You know, a cake tastes the best when it's baked the same day, you know. Chicken tastes the best when it comes out of the oven. So that's why. So what are we doing? Oh yeah, we just installed Cool Edit and yeah, we installed some other things, a DJ machine. I wanted to see if I could, you know, install something like Cubase on it. You know what is Cubase? Cubase, that is, yeah, but I don't have a good version that I can install. I don't have a demo version. Let me see if there's a demo version available. Demo, Cubase S3 or so. Let me see where I can find a demo. I'm not sure if it's still out there. These guys, they removed the demos, you know? No bloody link. Cubase, free to try. Let's see if this will work. Let's check this out, man. Try Cubase Elements. That is a little bit too much, I think. Cubase Pro. Don't you have older versions? No, of course not, because they are not selling that anymore. So the old versions, if you kept them, you will have them. And you know what Ubuntu did? Ubuntu removed the 32-bit version mini CD from
Look at this. Look what Ubuntu did. I still have mine. I still have mine. But look. On this side, they are going up to 18. And net images. Here. You see 19? This is version 19. And then when you hit on I386, boom, not found. You see? That was last week, I still downloaded it. They only want you to download the 64-bit. You see that? So the 1910 is not available anymore. And I would get, I have the netboot images. From 1904. Ubuntu Mini ISO. Let me see if I can find it. 1904. Because this is, in fact, yeah, crazy. They only release it as Disco Dingo. But you won't find the mini ISO, you won't find it anymore. Or the 32-bit. 32-bit. It's not there anymore. You see that? But I have them. I was so smart. Keep them, to give them a name. Yeah, I have them all. 12 1904, 32-bit, 14 16. Okay, 14 and 6, in fact these two I can delete because I will never ever use that crap. Delete. But hey, the 1904 32-bit I still have, so I can still make distros. I can still make distros. Other people in the world cannot anymore. If they don't have these files, they cannot. So I will create several 32-bit versions. Because, yeah, I will make a mate desktop. Hey, probably I'm gonna send you this file, Ruben. Then you can build on this file from here. We can build together. I will build 64-bit and you build 32-bit. That's what we're gonna do. Audacity is as well installed. This is an amazing recover project. Let me see what. Oh, nothing. Test, 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 test. Okay, microphone is on. Test, 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 test. You see that? When you make a distro, you're gonna write the distro. You go to configure the sound settings, and then the input you set to off. So when the people install it, it will always be set to off, so the thing is not listening. So yeah, you see, now it's listening, now it's off. Output, we have the sounds. This one you must put on. Okay, the sounds, okay, are not working. That is because Let me see what the boy did. Okay. Chimes. Oh, there you have all the sounds. Okay, let me see. What is the startup sound? Windows startup sound. Oh yeah, effect, we can leave it just like there. We can leave it there because we know where it is. So the only thing that you need to do is, if you kijk, where is the sound settings? Sound settings, only thing you need to do is go to sound and then you select this. You go to music, Windows 7 sounds, and Windows 7 startup sound. You see that? That's how to fix the sound. Music, Windows 7 sounds. Ik zei even leren hoe je dat de volgende keer moet doen, zodat de sounds altijd blijven. Sowieso de start-up en de afsluitgeluiden. Oké, Ruben? Daar is een trucje voor. Windows shutdown, log-off sound. Is dat de log-off sound? Oh nee, dat is toeten. How do you... What is shutdown? Windows shutdown. Kijk, wat je eigenlijk dan moet doen is die sounds en ook de backgrounds, die moeten in systeemfolders, oké? Maar dat ga ik je niet nu uitleggen, oké? Dat leg ik je wel via ander medium uit, oké? Zodat je dat kunt zien voor je, of tenminste, dat je daar notities van kunt maken. I don't want to save. Go away. No. All right. So, my friends, how many viewers? 4 viewers. Okay. Yeah. System is closing down now. It's late. It's people must go to bed. Ruben must as well go to bed. So, peeps, I hope you all subscribed at least to Ruben's channel, so he can give you the link. I will as well tomorrow. Upload the video that Ruben made, and then I'm gonna post it on my channel, and then I will put the download link, including the message that you must subscribe to his channel, in the description, so you can download this to try. Okay, please don't put it on some website and don't go sell it. Don't go do anything with it. It's just for you to play with, okay? Promise me that, please. Because, yeah, this is just, a souvenir, okay? See it that way. And as you can see, there are many things that you can do. You can make recordings with this, very easy. File, new. Boom. But we turned off the microphone. Is it recording? Testing. No, it will not record because the sound is set to off. So when you're gonna do these things, you go to the input and then you test. 1, 2, you see? Here you see the level meter. Sweet. So this is working really nice. So I'm gonna keep the system, Ruben. I'm gonna play with it a bit. I don't care too much that we cannot install Android into it. It's just fine. You know, it's nice to play with and great to fool your friends, because they will go behind it and they will probably install some application, some Windows application. And then the thing will as well work. Or maybe not. You know what as well works good? GTA San Andreas. GTA San Andreas works good on this thing. You can install it. I like this. Yeah. See. Let me see if this still works. This is old, peeps. What you're gonna see now is old. It's as well installing. Look at that. Amazing. Look at that. Do you guys know this game? Press bottom. What bottom? Shift. I can't remember what bottom I should press. No. I don't know what button to press. I think you need joystick for this also. Ah, shift. Oh, this is crazy. This is a stupid game. So where am I? I must get these things. Stupid. The thing was faster than my Atari. Come on. Ah, no, 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 no. Conquer. Ah! This is very old game, yo. I don't want to play anymore. I'm tired. But here you can see old games. They play fine. You can download them. everything is too slow, man. DRM, I'm gonna show you something. Our national public station. I'm gonna show you the difference. If I want to watch anything, the news, it should not play. You see? Here on top. You see that? DRM. If you don't enable that, you cannot watch national public TV. Hey, should a thing like that not be forbidden? How can it be that national public TV is pushing DRM to the watchers? This is not some commercial station. How is that possible? And when I go to Germany, as well Europe, our neighbors, ARD, mediatek.de, I think the address should be. Yeah? Look at these guys. Yeah? You come to their site. I'm in Holland. We hit here. We want to watch live TV. And you're watching live TV. You see, that is the difference between Germany and the Netherlands. Where you see DRM, you think that on this is no copyright? You think on this, on these videos are not copyright? Of course there is copyright on that. But they don't block the people from watching it. How is it possible that Germany can do this for their citizen without any advertisement? Huh? These guys, they don't come and pimp you off with advertisements that you must first watch. No, Germans are not like that. They are not. I'm not saying that those that play advertisements are bad. No, of course not. But, you know, I'm just saying, this is national public TV. Should that not be free for everybody to watch?
Wenn der Stabwechsel zwischen dem alten und
Why can the German people watch so much TV and we cannot? UK, the same thing. UK TV. Yeah. What do you want to watch? BBC One? Watch now. Oh, I must register. This is a stupid site. These are pimping of these guys. But hey, for real, you can. Let me see. Where I have them. Maybe I can show it to you. In fact, my S3 is empty. Otherwise, I would show you. I have several apps that you can download from the Play Store that will let you watch live UK TV, BBC One, BBC Two, BBC, any one of them. You see, so that is a little bit disappointing. That's why I don't watch Dutch TV. RTL, the same thing. RTL.nl, same thing. even for a news article, they immediately want to put let you hear first privacy. Did you see a thing like this when we went to Germany? That we get a warning that we must, you know, we must agree for no. So if Germany is not doing these things, and Germany is EU, why is Netherlands doing these kinds of things? Can somebody tell me about that? Why is Netherlands pimping off their viewers, national TV, that while the Germans don't do it? Here I must agree to several things. I don't want to agree to these things. So I don't watch them anymore. That's how simple it is. And you can live without them. You can live without cable TV. I gave up my cable TV long time ago because I was pissed off for one bill that they give to me, that they forget to send to me, and then 2 years later they come send me a bill from 2.5 years ago. And they as well had the brutality to put a fine onto that. So I had to pay more. I said, okay, no problem, I will pay it. And then I want you to immediately as well shut down my TV cable connection. Because I said, when I was getting internet from you guys over the cable, and I would be late with paying 1 month, I asked them, I said, if I was having this payment, why did you not shut down my TV? That's what I asked them. Then they said, that is not our policy. I said, oh, but when I had internet from you guys over the cable, and I was late with paying my internet, you did shut down my TV as well. You did not only shut down my internet, but as well my TV. They said, yes. I said, well, you guys have strange policies, so I want you to immediately shut down my cable connection. I don't want TV from you guys anymore, okay? I have a satellite disc, and I will find my own TV, including with internet. And then I got a letter from them that they shut down my TV. And then I was really happy, so I went to my self-built computer that would be my TV station. I was completely prepared for that. So I got a letter from them, and then they said that they shut down the TV. I was shutting down. And then I was very happy. I went upstairs to my computer, I connected to my TV, I put on my TV, and then I saw that these idiots did not even cut me off. TV was just playing fine and all the stations. That while I, you know, ended my deal with them. So the next day I went to them, I said, listen, I want black on white, we're gonna make a paper that I will never ever get a bill from you ever again, ever. Because I will not ever do any business with you in your company. So I want you to put that on paper, that I paid everything and I will never ever get any bill from you ever again. And then we signed a paper, you know, that I will never get a bill from them because I paid everything and everything is cleared and, you know, we and them have no business anymore. And then I went home, lie down on my couch, and enjoyed TV until one day, I don't know how long, I could not count the time, after many years, I think, they finally shut it down for real. They thought maybe I would, you know, because it's a whole work for them to actually shut down the signal, because probably then other neighbors will have a problem. I don't know what their problem was, but it was not mine. But that's how I got rid from my TV company. You know, it's not my fault that they sent me a letter that they shut it down and they did not. But they're not gonna let me pay for that, for their mistake. Absolutely not. So I was the last laughing person in this complete case, and I never ever did business with them ever again. Yeah, these guys are crooks. Crooks. They let people pay for nonsense. for something that is free. Yeah, that's how it went, Bob. And even though they did not cut down the stream, I was never looking at TV anymore. The thing was always running my own Chromecast, because then I got pissed off that they did not shut it down. But I thought, I'm not going to tell them. Because they did not want to... They also wanted me to pay for something from 2 years ago. That was their fault, because they changed from name. They first had different name, and then they changed from name. And then suddenly 2 years later, they are coming with old bills from, you know, way back that they did not... These are crazy people, yo. So I'm not part of them. I have a good internet connection. That is all to me that I need. I don't need anything more than a good internet connection, my friends. Nothing more you need to survive. A good internet connection. Invest your money in that. You know that you have a good upload, a good download. It's not about the download so much to me. It's more about the upload. I can upload a video really fast to YouTube, really fast. Normally, when I would upload, it was the download was really fast, but the upload was some KB per second. That was crazy. It took hours. That's why my quality videos from years ago were always, you know, in a low quality, because, yeah, if I would make them full HD, then it would take 24 hours. I don't know how long to upload with this stupid provider that I had. Now I have the very best provider, I think, from the Netherlands. They are the best. They are the boss of the network. Never go for secondary companies that are using the main network from some company. Go for the main network and never go away from them. Always stay with them. That's how I see it. For real. So yeah, we did many things. We played with the system. It's working good. I'm gonna give this system to my brother Eric. He's gonna love it, although he wants 64 bit. Misschien moet je de volgende keer 64 bit maken, broertje. En doe het alsjeblieft op Ubuntu. Alsjeblieft. Want Linux Mint, ja, die maken wel leuke besturingssystemen, maar er klopt iets niet in de boot van hun. Hun boot klopt niet. Klopt iets niet. Er is iets vreemds met daar, bij de boot, bij de grub. Ik weet niet wat ze hebben gedaan. Ze hebben het een beetje, ja, vreemd ingericht. Ik weet het niet. Het werkt gewoon niet. Maar voor de rest, wow, look at these windows, look at this skin. This is just like I'm sitting in front of a Windows system, guys, really. And this is GNU. It's a replica. It's not the real thing. It's not Windows. Even though it looks like Windows, it's not. Here you have several themes. You can as well make the thing look like Windows 10. You see that? Here is the theme, the desktop theme. Here you can get even more. Here you have a 7 light, 10 light team. Somewhere here. This one is as well fun to test. Oh, you already installed it. Okay, I see it. All right, nice. I don't see it, but it's all good. Nice, man. Okay, that was it. Such a long show. Is anyone talking? Or are you just listening? You're all lying in bed and trying to fall asleep. It's still fun. Who is still in here? Is Bob, is Matty still in here? Or did Matty fall asleep? Hey, jij moet naar bed 024. Is veel te laat voor jou, jongen. Je moet morgen werken. Ik ga deze show afsluiten. Okay. We're going to close the show. Yeah. O24 must go to work tomorrow. And he must wake up around 8 o'clock. So, you know, he needs some rest. And me, myself, as well. I had a nice show here with you all. Yeah, I enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed it as well. I want to thank you for joining the show. All the likes, I see a whole lot of likes. Thank you very much for that. And Ruben also thanks all of you that enjoyed this, what you saw. Don't forget, you cannot get the download link from me because I did not create the system. It's from Ruben. So I'm going to send you to Ruben's YouTube. And up there you can subscribe to his channel and then get the download link. And then you're going to keep it to yourself. And yeah, don't do crazy things with it. It's only for you to test and to have. Okay? That was it. Nou, dankjewel Ruben. En dankjewel luisteraars en kijkers. Ik hoop dat jullie genoten hebben van deze live show. Ik heb zeker genoten. En ik zeg goodbye. Zwaai zwaai. En stay well. Bye bye everybody. Ja. Yeah. WT en Flashing. Goodbye. Bob. En all of you there. Ja. Yeah. You guys are all very nice people. And much love from Channel 48. Yeah, don't mind me too much when I, you know, show videos about old phones. They also need, you know, this development. There are ROMs out there and we can still use these things. And we can at least still make a video about them. And maybe one day you can get one free and then you can dig into my project and as well do the thing, you know, and create a nice little device that you're gonna give away to some kid or somebody or, you know, or play with yourself whenever you're gonna be bored, you know, because these things, they stay interesting. They are all computers, these phones, very powerful computers, some of them more powerful than this laptop that you see here in front of me. So yeah, let's take advantage out of that and enjoy these beautiful moments we can have with these devices. Again, thank you and see you in the next video. Bye bye.